Welcome back for episode 72 of Count Me In, IMA's podcast about all things affecting the accounting and finance world. I'm your host, Mitch Roshong, and the episode I am introducing is a conversation between our co-host, Ruba Zidan, and Marwan Al-Suwaidi, a seasoned finance specialist and the director of finance and the procurement support services department at Khalifa Fund. In this episode, Ruba and Marwan discuss the future of small to medium-sized enterprises in the Gulf Cooperation Council, and the role the Abu Dhabi-based Khalifa Fund is playing in supporting this fundamental segment of the economy. They also talk about how businesses can sustain and reinvent their models following COVID-19, so keep listening for another insightful and valuable episode of Count Me In.
So let's start with the Khalifa Fund, which is the company that you represent. It was established in 2007 as an independent, not-for-profit SMEs socioeconomic development agency by the government of Abu Dhabi. The fund was originally set up to support the culture of investment amongst UAE nationals and developing, obviously, the SME investments in the Emirates. What was the vision behind such an initiative by Abu Dhabi?
Prior to 2007, let's say, actually no one was providing loans to small and medium enterprises. So there was a vague, gap in the market. So Khalifa Fund was established to take a position that banks shy to take it, financial institutions shy to take it also. So the main idea or the main wisdom of creating Khalifa Fund is to nurture the SME ecosystem in Abu Dhabi first. Then by 2011, we moved to the entire UAE. So that was the main wisdom behind, or the main vision or wisdom behind creating Khalifa Fund, is to encourage UAE nationals to go to the private sector by establishing their own firms. Take some employment from the public sector to the private sector, and provide a financing vehicle that banks and financial institutions did not take that step at that time.
Okay. And initially, I mean, in 2015, you'd started for local purposes, national purposes, but then eventually in 2015, the Khalifa Fund diversified its efforts internationally with a portfolio of some $1 billion across 22 countries in three different continents, Africa, Asia, and Europe. How were these regions selected, and what are some of the promising industries that the fund is actually looking out for and mostly interested in?
See, this mainly going international came from a direction from His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed, Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. So the main idea also to support the friend countries to boost their economy through creating employment in the country. So that was the main wisdom behind going to international. We have, for example, Chechen Republic, mainly there for innovation. Belarus, also in the innovation sector. We have innovation sector because we see that there is a big market or an encouragement to the society there to move to that. So we analyze the country before going there, and we find potential areas that can be developed in that country and can support the main mission, which is creating employment and enhancing the ecosystem.
So mostly it revolves around innovation across various sectors. So you're looking for new ideas, fresh new concepts. According to the Credit Bureau, the total credit for SMEs in the UAE totaled $24 billion by end of last year. How is that figure expected to increase or decrease under the current economic developments resulting from, obviously, COVID-19 pandemic?
The COVID-19 is a tipping point. And I think the economy will be different. So the methodology of the regular loan provided to the prior to COVID will be different post-COVID. So entrepreneurs will be different. people who are going to go into the market, they need to be agile and flexible, and the sector, priority sectors and clusters will be different. So we cannot say like it's going to increase or decrease, because it will not be compared to the prior to COVID. This is something else that we're going to talk about.
Would you imagine it to be stronger than it was pre-COVID?
I think, COVID-19 is very challenging for the SME sector.
Mm-hmm.
So SMEs who's going to survive during COVID-19 will end up learning a lot of things that they never learned before. So the solid will be much strong for them. And they can easily build on that. Entrepreneurs who did not survive during COVID-19, but saw how the market changed, they're going to come back with different mindset, with different approach to the market. So I think SMEs will be performing much better than before COVID-19.
A positive perspective. As it should be, of course. So when looking at, for example, the stats for SMEs globally and even regionally, it's a fairly similar scenario across the board, in the sense that they represent the biggest percentage of the private sector businesses, and they employ the largest workforce. For example, if we zoom in on the UAE, they represent more than 60% of the non-oil GDP and 94% of the total number of companies that are operating in the country. And when you look at the job spectrum, they provide more than 86% of the private sector workforce. That's according to the Ministry of Economy. So what is the government doing to help them get through this critical phase, which stands to have, as you mentioned earlier, a tremendous impact? In some cases, it's going to mean everything with regards to survival.
The government introduced many government stimulus. One of them is the targeted economic support scheme. The 50 billion dirham that was given to the banks. So the banks will do support, financial support to the SME out of their balance sheet, let's say. So which was came like a heavy relaxation to the bank. The bank would be able to provide financial support to the affected SMEs by waiving a lot of fees, by waiving not taking the installment during waiving the installment in the next 3 to 6 months, plus providing loans like for the working capital, because again COVID-19 affected mainly with the working capital, the cash operating cycle. So the banks are more relaxed now because they're going to provide the fund off their balance sheet. This is one thing. On the local governments, each like Emirate has its own government stimulus to the SME. So I think UAE, one of the best countries who proacted into supporting the economy, beginning of March 2020. So I think the UAE government acted very fast.
Yeah, I definitely second that motion. I'm based in the UAE, have been for the past 40 years. And to be honest, I mean, when you contrast this globally, I feel very privileged to be in this area at this critical time. They've really been wonderful at and agility, as you mentioned, as a crucial kind of attribute at this point. So in a survey conducted by the Pearl Initiative, they found that 70% of SMEs that were surveyed in Saudi Arabia and UAE stated that, amongst the numerous challenges that they face, such as economic conditions, finding experienced personnel, they also noted a key one that comes to mind, which is raising capital. So if this was already a challenge for them, this was a survey done in Q4 of last year. So if this was a challenge, raising capital was a challenge in Q4 of 2019, can we assume that it's going to be even more challenging post-COVID-19? And what are some of the criteria that funds like Khalifa will be looking for?
As we said earlier, I think the approach toward the SMEs will be different prior to COVID-19 and post-COVID-19. So post-COVID-19, people or entrepreneurs who are going to survive will look at the business and the economy from different perspective. New entrepreneurs, new entrants to the market will have different approach. Again, we know that innovation played a critical role during COVID-19. Most of the businesses who are able to move fast from being a normal shop to online, they get a bigger market share than people who did not reacted. People who moved, or like so businesses that moved from, if we take, for example, the tailor shops, men tailor shop or women tailor shop. These tailors, some of them we know that they have moved to tailoring masks, face masks, surgical masks. So those have benefited from the COVID-19. Against other shops, tailor shop in the same industry, in the same sector, who did not react and waited just customers to come to them and do the fitting. So the approach will be different. Again, entrepreneurs will be looking more instead of looking at I need a loan or I need a capital. They're going to be more specific into needing, like, for example, procurement financing. We need working capital financing. So I think these are much cheaper or has a lower value than having a big capital. This is one thing. The second, we said that the government has provided stimulus from the central bank to the banks. They will be able to provide loans to SMEs upon having a good feasibility study. So the approach is different. This is from debt financing. We have another thing, which is equity financing. Equity financing, we know that this region is developing in the private equity and the venture capital market. So we'll see. We have Ghadan 21, which is promoting private equity, promoting angel investment, promoting venture capitals to come in. So I think the approach will be different. So we can see like challenges to get to raise capital. No, it's about the type of capital needed for their businesses.
And do you think this is going to take time? I mean, or is this something that will still be ongoing as we progressively come out of COVID-19?
Ruba, did we thought one day that we will work from home as good as we were working from the offices?
Absolutely not. I mean, I personally did, but not everyone.
Not everyone, majority of the people, but we're functioning well. We're keeping the things as smooth as possible. We changed on the personal level, and that reflected on the way we do our businesses. We teach our children at home, and they're getting grades similar to the way they study there in the school. So we found some skills, hidden skills in ourselves that wasn't there. So similarly, we apply this on the macro level, on the economy level. Of course, these entrepreneurs, they have shifted their thinking. And we know most of them, if you do a survey about COVID will end. COVID-19 will end. I mean, the economic cycle, but people mindset will be different.
Yes, absolutely. It is one of those transformational kind of experiences. There has been a recent announcement that Abu Dhabi is set to allocate 15% of procurement spending and annual contracts to SMEs as part of the country's economic stimulus package. So how involved is Khalifa Fund with this mandate? And what do you believe, in your opinion, is the desired outcome from this?
See, this is, again, the government of Abu Dhabi announced 15% plus paying all the invoices in less than 15 days. So that will contribute heavily to the operating cash cycle of the entrepreneurs. SMEs are very sensitive to the cash. So by having the government buying from SMEs, like 15% of their the government budget will go to the SME. The SME will have more cash that they can operate within, like higher, get increase the level of employment, increase the, of their level of output,
or maintain their level of output and level of employment.
I think yes, maintain, but it's more to like trying. This will increase, of course, the level of their output. Khalifa Fund is coordinating with the Department of Support government because that government is the one who's behind this initiatives. So we're trying to coordinate with them and sign an agreement which will allow all members of Khalifa Fund to participate in the government procurement. This is from the government level, but from Khalifa Fund itself, we have that since a long time. We have two KPI, which is the procurement percentage of procurement. We have it 15%, and we have number of transactions with applicant. So we do support them financially and through procurement.
Okay. Excellent initiatives, by the way, especially in this dire phase, you know, where people assume that activity has really slowed down. So it's good to see that, you know, initiatives are still running. What advice do you have for SMEs at this crucial point in time as they struggle to keep their heads above water, keep their employees? What advice do you have to give them?
I advise all SMEs is to think about the opportunities of this challenge. Of course, there are many opportunities that arise from COVID-19. Look at that and see your production cycle, how you can change it or to fit the new requirements of the market. Try to connect with the cyberly with your customers, keep them, engage with them. Maybe they are not going to have the purchasing power will be low now, but in future we at least you will be there. Your employees, you need to keep them engaged. Try to brainstorm new ideas how to move your businesses. For example, if you are a restaurant, now you're a restaurant, you are only allowed 30% of capacity. So what you'll do? Focus more or shift your strengths to more into delivery. How you will do that? Through tie up with delivery channels like Deliveroo, Tawseel, Talabat. So try to find new windows for your businesses.
Excellent advice. I mean, it's finding, you know, opportunities within the adversity of the situation. So it's a very warranted approach. I think that's the only way to come out of this, if you try to find a strand of hope and opportunity. So that's been amazing advice and amazing feedback and input. Thank you so much, Marwan. It's a pleasure to have this chat with you this afternoon.
Thank you, Robo. Thank you.
This has been Count Me In, IMA's podcast, providing you with the latest perspectives of thought leaders from the accounting and finance profession. If you like what you heard and you'd like to be counted in for more relevant accounting and finance education, visit IMA's website at www.imanet.org.